companies do not like to take the risk of going to a completely new college who they don't know anything about. So, but obviously, after 2 to 3 years, the situation becomes much better.
Hello, viewer. We have with us Akidat Kaur. She is from Punjab, Kharar. She has scored 95.78 percentile in the CAT 2019 last year. Prior to that CAT examination, she has done her BTEC. Right. Before we go ahead and have a discussion regarding your CAT preparation and everything, I just wanted to know ki aapki family background kaisi.
So my mother was a professor in a government college under the course of zoology, and my father is residing in the US. He was a software engineer earlier. So that's my family background. Typical, normal middle class family. So and my education was first I was living in Patiala. So my initial years were in YPS Patiala. Then I went to Wellman Girls School, Dehradun. Then I went. Then I came back to Patiala to coach, I had to basically take admission into the IITs. And non-medical is something that you do when you're good at science. That's what told to us. So then I decided to prepare, and I got through IIT Jammu. My branch was electrical engineering. But eventually, I realized that engineering is not my call exactly. So I was interested more in management, and especially because it's IIT Jammu is a new IIT. So we had to literally micro and macro manage everything. So I really got to know about myself through that. And I realized that I am going to eventually do an MBA. First, I was thinking that maybe some work experience would benefit me more. So that's why actually last year I hadn't prepared for the CAT examination. So this score is my literal first mock attempt. So
So superb.
Thank you. But now I'm preparing for it. I got through IIM Indore, but I decided to give it another try. And now I'm again preparing for the CAT examination, and I'm hoping to make it to IIM A, B or C.
Okay, that's what you target, A, B or C, right?
Yeah.
Can you tell me a bit about your preparation? I mean, you said that probably this was your first mock. So did you not prepare through any coaching center, or did you not prepare yourself at home?
I was in college at that time. So last year was my fourth year in engineering. So at that time, I was still speculating over whether I should go for some work experience or go directly as a fresher. But then I decided to go with work experience. So I did not prepare. Even presently, I'm not taking coaching from any institute, I've taken two test series, and I'm regularly giving my mocks. So that's very essential. So last year, I think the main difference is that I did not have any performance pressure. So that really benefits. So that's maybe I got a very good score. That was a major reason. So yeah. So that's, I think, the main difference between this year and last year.
So where are you taking the mock this year from?
I started with Career Launcher, and now I'm giving time.
So by your own preparation, like studying at home?
I haven't taken any books, but they have topic-wise questions. So you do topic-wise questions, and then you do sectionals. I had some books from some family friend of mine. So I took some time booklets, but I did only quant. From that, and just a few questions to get myself familiar with the type of questions that come in CAT.
CAT 19 देने के पहले कितने महीने preparation आपने ली थी CAT की?
I just started in August this year, so it's been I think 3 to 4 months you could say of proper preparation.
What about previous year?
I hadn't taken any preparation.
So it was a sudden day you appeared for CAT.
Even just the day before the exam, I was chilling with my friends. I was like, okay, I just have to give an exam. It's not like I prepared for it. I have no stress. But it's just that I decided to go for it now because of COVID, the work experience, the kind of work experience I desired, I did not get that. So I had to kind of change my strategy.
When you're going for CAT this year, how many months did you work for? I mean, prior, after your BTEC?
I actually have a job offer from Cognizant. So our job offers were delayed by a long time. Actually, we have to join in a few months, maybe in 1 or 2 months. So we're just completing those formalities. So fortunately, I don't have work pressure. because with that it would have been very difficult, especially starting a job and then you are preparing for the CAT examination. It's quite a difficult process. So that way I've been lucky. I have had ample time because I started preparing late. But
So इस साल आप अगस्त से प्रिपेयर कर रही हो, सो इट्स बीन ऑलमोस्ट 2-3 मंथ्स. व्हाट इज द टाइमिंग व्हिच यू आर मेंटेनिंग टू प्रिपेयर योरसेल्फ फॉर कैट?
सो फर्स्ट आई वाज गिविंग मॉक्स ऑफ 3 आवर्स, नाउ इट्स सडनली ऑफ 2 आवर्स, एंड ऑब्वियसली विद थिंग्स कीप चेंजिंग, राइट? सो यू हैव योर शेड्यूल कीप्स चेंजिंग, बट ऑन एन एवरेज आई थिंक 5 आवर्स एट लीस्ट. 5 आवर्स
ऑन अ डेली बेसिस यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग योरसेल्फ फॉर द कैट. What is your strategy, if you can highlight bit on that part, how you are preparing yourself?
So what, obviously, the fact that I gave my CAT exam last year really helped, because I came to know that I have the ability of cracking CAT without taking any coaching or really fueling myself out. So that's why I directly decided to go for the test series. Mm-hmm. And
do you have any proper strategy for quant, logical reasoning, or
firstly I just started with mocks, right? So you don't really, you're kind of trying to understand what your strategy should be, because everyone should have a different strategy according to the strengths and weaknesses. So for someone like me, I know that at the time of the exam I might mess up with my time management. Tend to get very emotional with the questions we are attempting, that, oh, I have to get this question right. So sometimes that happens. And I actually try to really be in that final exam mode. And I do get emotional, and then you just get stuck onto that tough question. And obviously, all these mocks also, their levels keep varying. So sometimes some are difficult, some are easy. So you're sometimes getting a very good score, sometimes you're barely scoring above 100. So that really, so basically you have to keep changing. That's the strategy. You have to modify your strategy, your attempt according to the level of the exam.
Do you do any kind of analysis after your exam?
So now, considering it's a 2-hour mock, right? So considering if the paper was easy, then it barely takes 2 hours, not more than 2 hours at all. But if it was a difficult level, like time, exam series are difficult, so I take around 4 hours. The experience was amazing. It's not a very typical IIT experience, considering it was very new. You do not have any clubs or any societies which are already formed. You just have to be a part of it. So we had to start everything from scratch.
Okay.
But we were under the mentorship of IIT Delhi. So they were very supportive. And I think they helped to really form our college the way it is now. Now we are in a permanent campus, and the batches are doing very well. We have, like, almost all our labs are set up. So obviously we were the first batch, so we did suffer in some way because considering placements. Companies do not like to take the risk of going to a completely new college who they don't know anything about. Mm-hmm. So, but obviously after 2 to 3 years, the situation becomes much better. Yeah.
Right.
That's the only drawback I faced.
IIT is a big name in the Indian market, although it's a new campus. But people know that they are very, very selective while taking the students. So selection companies should have considered brand IIT than that of any new.
The problem is that they know that there are not many labs in the first year. So obviously it takes time to set up a lab. Then obviously when core companies come to your college, they know that you won't have done many experiments or projects relating to it. So that becomes difficult. So core companies do not really come, but like especially IT and CS related jobs were ample. So that way people ended up doing well. But it was a little, we didn't have many options. But obviously, after 2 years, the situation will obviously be much better. Okay. It's happened with IIT Ropar, Mandi, so we know what happened. Eventually, it's all right. Yeah.
Right. What is the current timing which you are maintaining, and how you are preparing yourself on a daily basis?
So I try to give a mock every day, And it, I mean, sometimes obviously if I'm busy one day, then I skip the mock the next day and I analyze the previous one. So that's how it goes. And if I feel that one section is weak or I really need to change my strategy, then there's a lot of content on YouTube. There are many amazing people who are giving out free content related to CAT preparation. So that's something I check out. Yes, I do not get a very personalized strategy. I mean, you have to really make it, or you have to go seek help from coaches. But yeah, I mean, whatever you can do by yourself, I think that's something I'm trying to do.
Awesome. Awesome. Can you give any kind of suggestions to the people who are appearing for the CAT for the first time this year?
So considering the pattern has changed a bit, and I saw many videos where people were saying that, oh my God, what will happen now? We've been giving so many mocks for 3 hours. Suddenly it's 2 hours. How do we change it? So actually the point is that the management exam, it's an admission exam, right? So they want to check your management skills. That's exactly what they want to see. So if you get scared by, oh my God, this timing has suddenly changed. What if the whole pattern changes? What questions will come? How many questions will come? If we become so frantic about that, then there's no point of going to a business school. I mean,
True. It
defeats the whole purpose. So I think that's something you really need to get over, that yes, anything might come. We shouldn't be expecting something just because someone's predicting that, okay, this will come, that will come. We should go according to that strategy alone. So it's important to modify. It's important to go with a clear head and just focus on whatever you have worked upon and not think of something completely different on that day. Like, okay, fine, I'll try something new, which I have never tried in my mocks before. So that's something very important. And right now, focus on your mocks and analyze.
As much as possible, right?
As much as possible.
Primarily for 2 hours mock and then 2 hours analysis. Will that be okay?
Yeah, I think. Depends on the level of the mock. Yeah. So okay. I think 3 hours on an average should suffice.
Great, great. Wonderful. So have you decided what a specialization are you going to go in an MBA?
I haven't, because I honestly don't want to. But I'll see in my first semester what really suits me, what I want to do ahead in my life. So according to that, I don't want to constrain myself like that.
It was really nice talking to you, Akidat. Thank you so much. Have a great time ahead.